Dear students, I welcome all of you in the another session of transportation engineering. So as you all know that we are discussing the second segment that is majorly focused on the highway transportation sector. We have learned about the highway geomatic design and its importance, and in this session we'll move towards the another topic that is one of the most important topic of highway transportation, that is segment number 2, and the name of the particular topic is cross-sectional element of roads. We are going to discover, we are going to learn various kind of elements that are the part of cross-section of road. Let us discuss that what we are going to learn. We will have the detailed understanding that how the cross-section of the road looks like, what are its basic elements, and why those elements are provided at those places. What are the reasons to provide those elements, why they are provided, and what are the importance. The first is about formation level and ground level. See, formation level and ground level, this is the one of the basic things that we need to learn. See, before learning the cross section of road and its elements, we need to have the proper knowledge of what is formation level and what is ground level. Whenever you are traveling on the road, you may have observed that sometimes the surface of the road on which the vehicles are traveling, on the surface on which you are traveling, is quite higher than the ground level, and it looks like this. See, in this particular scenario, this is the surface on which you are traveling, and this is the ground level, and this is the slope which is being provided. See, this particular thing is called as formation level on which the vehicles or we are traveling, and this is the ground level. Sometimes whenever you are traveling through any hilly region, you may observe that the section of the road is in cutting and you have to travel on this surface, and in the surrounding this kind of mountains are provided. So in those context, these are called as the ground level and this is called as the formation level. So there is a difference of height, difference of slope between ground level and formation level. Formation level means simply the level on which you are traveling. Ground level means the basic ground level. This particular difference, this height difference, this height difference is called as cross slope or embankment. So this is what you need to understand. Now let us learn about other element. This is the basic idea of cross section of road and its elements. See, first comes the contour line, then comes the building line, then comes the boundary line. Then this is the CW. CW stands for carriageway. Don't try to memorize or mug up anything, just understand what I am going to narrate, what I am narrating. This is the carriageway, these are the shoulders, then comes the side slopes, then comes the bump, this is the toe part, these are the longitudinal drains, this is the boundary stone, this is boundary line, and this is contour line. And this whole summation of contour line and boundary line distance is called as cutback distance, and we also call as border. Now we will learn in detail what is the motive of providing all this element. See, first is the carriageway, CW. It ranges from this point to this point. This particular area is called as carriageway. Carriageway is the surface on road on which we, means pedestrian or vehicle, can travel. The surface that we use to travel on the road is called as carriageway. So this is carriageway. See, whenever we are traveling on the road, we may observe there are two patches whose boundary are marked with the white color at the sides of road, either side of road or both sides of road. That particular boundaries are called as shoulders. If we combine this carriageway and shoulder, then this total particular segment is called as FW, that means formation bit. Then this is about the embankment or cross slope or side slope. This is bump, this is toe, this is longitudinal drain. This is how it looks like whenever we are discussing about the 3D segment. See, you can observe this is how it looks like in the 3D. Now let us discuss one by one all the segments. This is the cross section of the road whenever the road is constructed on embankment. See, this is the formation line and this is the ground level NGL. This is camber, this is shoulder, this is side slope, these are bound, these are side drains, road boundary, building line and control. You need to have the knowledge of this particular status analysis. Let us discuss about camber first. What is camber? See, camber is the slope that connects the edge of road to the crown of the road. This is the crown of the road. See this point, which is the highest point on the road surface. If road is like this, then it will be like this. And this particular higher segment is called as crown of the road. It is the higher point and it helps the water to get drain off from the surface. And this point, the crown connects to the edge and this slope is called as, cross slope is called as camber. So that is the definition of camber. And we need to have the knowledge of carriageway also. So carriageway, this is the carriageway, see. This whole thing, from this point to this point, is called as carriageway on which the vehicle can travel. We may have observed number of times or heard that this is a two-lane road, this is a three-lane road, this is multi-lane road. Then what is this thing? So let me tell you that the carriageway which is intended for one line of movement is called as traffic lanes. There are various criteria of traffic lanes such as the single row lane road will have the width of 3.75 meters. If it is of two lanes, it will have 7 meters. If boundary is raised, means it is called as curve, that it is called as 7.50 meters. And if it is of multi-lane, that you can observe in the Gandhinagar, it is of 3.50 meters per lane. Now let us discuss about shoulders. See, shoulders are provided along the road edge. They are used as the emergency lane. And as per IRC, there are minimum criteria that the minimum width of shoulder should be 2.5 meter if the terrain is plain. And it should be minimum 0.9 meters if it is of hilly area. If they are used for the purpose of repair, slow moving vehicle, overtaking operations, then emergency lanes, temporary diversions, temporary parking. Let us have a look how it looks like. See. These are the shoulders. They are provided at the edge of the carriageway. Whenever you are moving, you can park your vehicle temporarily for here, you can hold your vehicle for the repair work. And in future, this particular land area can also be used to widen the road. So this is called a shoulder. Now, let us discuss about, see, this is shoulder. This is shoulder. This is shoulder. This is shoulder. Now, this is carriageway. These are the lanes. This is one lane, this is another lane, this is another lane. If we combine the carriageway with shoulder, then the total particular width, carriageway plus shoulder, total width will be called as formation width. There are certain criteria that we need to have knowledge about. That if it is of national highway or state highway, then for the planing and plane and rolling terrain, it should be 12 meters. If it is of mountainous or steeper terrain, then it should be of 6.25 to 8.8 meters. Then comes the MDR category, then comes the ODR category, and then comes the VR category. Let us discuss about right of way. See, right of way means the distance from one building stone to another building stone, or one boundary stone to another boundary stone. Right of way means the total land acquired for the purpose of construction of road. The total road that we acquire to construct the road is called as the right of way. See, these are carriageway, this is shoulder, this total is called as formation width, these are margins, and from this point to this point, this total land acquired is called as right of way or total. These are certain criteria that you need to have knowledge about. Then comes the side slope. As I have already discussed, that it is the slope of the earthwork, either in cutting or in filling, it is called as side slope. It imparts stability to the earthwork. It provides the stability to the earthwork. It provides the stability to the road. And it should be as flat as possible. See, these are the side slope. It provides stability to this particular road structure. See, this part and this part provide stability to this. It is like this. If this is the total embankment, the road will be like this. So it will be standing on that particular part. Then comes the berm part. Berm is the distance between the road toe and the inner edge. See, the road toe and the inner edge of the borrow pit is called as berm. Then comes side drain. Side drains is called as drainage or gutters. These are the side drains that you can observe in the city areas. In Ahmedabad city, they are not provided like this. They are provided from the longitudinal direction. See the nets, you can observe the those particular nets over the surface of the road. They are used to drain off the water from both the sides so that the water cannot get percolated with the pavement materials and it should not deteriorate the condition of the particular road surface. Then comes about the building line. See, this is building line. This is building line and this is building line distance. It is the distance from the center line of the road on the either side within which the construction of building is not permitted. You cannot construct any building within this area or within this area. So from this point to this point, we cannot construct any building. It is not permitted at all. So that particular line that shows the restriction of construction of building is called as building line. As I have already mentioned that it is used for the future road widening, reduction of accident, used to reduce the pollution, relieve the traffic issues, etc. Then comes curbs. See, curbs are the boundaries between pavement and shoulders or the footpath. You have observed this on the surface of flyovers. They look like this. See, you have observed this? They are like this. See, these are the curve. This is curve and this is curve. This white surface. This raised boundary is called as curve. As per IRC, the minimum width of that particular curve is not fixed because it depends upon various types. But the thing that you people call it as the, what I can say, what you people call it? Divider, okay. The divider thing is technically called as median or traffic separator, and the minimum width of particular median is half meter if it is of a normal highway, and for bridges it is lesser up to 1.2 meter. There are three types of curves, three types of boundaries, such as low or mountable curves. Second is semi barrier curves, and then comes the barrier. They look like this. They look like this. See, these are the lower mountable curves. It is having the height of up to 100 mm, means 10 cm. Vehicle can easily pass from this point to this point. Then comes the semi-barrier type. It is having more height, 150 mm up to 15 cm. It is having 1:1 slope. The vehicle cannot cross and cannot overturn from this point. So this is restrictive one. And the most difficult and the more what I can say is the difficult curve is barrier type. It acts as a barrier, that is why its name is barrier. It is having the height of 20 cm, and the horizontal to vertical slope is 1:4. You cannot climb from this point to this point. Sometimes in some of the cities of world and India also, the engineers are also providing submerged shoulders and submerged curves. But they are not being used majorly. See, this is longitudinal drain which they are provided in Ahmedabad actually, and these are called as curves. This is curve. These are curves. See, this is raised boundary. You can observe. It looks like this. Fine. I have covered most of the things of the elements of the road. The remaining thing we will cover in the next session. I hope you have understood the concept thoroughly. Thank you so much.